Okay, that looks like it's working. Right. Welcome back. We are playing Outer Wilds. Now, this is part 6. And I think we're close to something. I don't think we're there yet. We're not at the end, but getting there. We have explored a lot of the mysteries with the Giant's Deep. We think we've only got one more to go, which is the reverse cycling. Everything to do with Dark Bramble I've still got to do. And the Quantum Moon. Ooh, that was loud. So, let's give it a go. I kind of really feel like I should explore my homeworld a bit more again. I'm kind of feeling like more at home at space. Okay, so nothing new. So yeah, the next thing is Dark Bramble, really, isn't it? Feldspar headed off to Dark Bramble after reaching the core of Giant's Deep. Okay. So maybe I do need to do that first. I mean, probably don't need to do that first. I feel like very little in this game needs you to go in a certain order. Let's try that then. Like, I'm scared of Dark Bramble. Let's go to Giant's Deep. See what we shall see. If we hit a wall there, then Dark Bramble it is. Saddle Rock. There's the twins, Giant's Deep. No, Giant's Deep is where I'm going. So we are looking for a cyclone going the wrong way. And there will only be good times to be had in it. Good times, fun times, happy joy. Anti-clockwise. Oh, we're here, lads. Can we just fly straight through this horrible looking... Oh. Giant EMP. This seems safe. I'm gonna regret this, aren't I? Let's just see if I can go without my ship. Because I don't need electricity. Obviously. Ending regrets. No, okay. We are okay. Where's my ship? Oh no. Where's my ship? Maybe there is a gap somewhere I can get in. Because I remember something about Feldspar saying he could get in without... Something about being executed. Let's take a gander. see things sticking out of it. I don't know if that's useful to me, like that one actually protruding the looks of it. Guessing like if we just see the red, oh yeah, we see the red. That's bad times. Do anything with the jellyfish. I'm not seeing anything in particular. Maybe that's something I have to. Oh, no, 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 no. I have to talk to Feldspar and figure out how he did it. See me, I can. Oh. No. That is not the key. Jellyfish! I think I'm probably using the scouter to see if I can do anything with that, but I doubt it, because it's still electrical, you know? Thunk! Yeah. Still works, but he bounced. Hey, you can just fire a scout at you. Bounced off the squid. Jellyfish. Oh, he does. Boing. Is there anything in the notes? Is there anything in these notes? The ocean is surprisingly calm beneath the current. Some sort of electrical field surrounds the planet's core. Grey mean I've explored everything to do with it? Because if so, then I've got a lot to do. I'm sure at some point it told me how this worked. Ooh. That's kind of funky. This would have been very useful to have known earlier. Statues were designed to only activate once the Ash Twin project succeeded, or in the event that it failed. Spark Hampton. Maybe if I just go back there, see if I can check his notes again. I swear he said something about the electrical field. Can we just leave, or do we need to? Yep, we can. Ooh. That's cool. Alright, so we can find Bramble Island. There's also space and ship. Island? Oh, my Statue Island. still need to stand on Thatcher Island when that happens. Well, that's what's his face's island. That's the construction yard. Where's the one island I want to see? There it is. Like a glove. What is that? Then? If these are just the jellyfish, which they are now, I was questioning whether these were something else. But what is the glowy thing? Can't believe I wasn't electrocuted. Oh, I can't bother to tell them about this one. I guess brute force wasn't always the answer. Oh, thanks, Feldspar. That's really useful. Great, great sciencing. Doesn't seem to be anything, but it's so weird that that is literally nowhere else. Oh well, not much I can do about it. Okay, Dark Bramble it is. Let's go have words. Oh no, there's more glowy stuff there, but... My nemesis, where are you? That's Wild Station. There you are. Looks like the quantum moon showed up. So all we know is the anglerfish are mostly blind, or all blind. So maybe just not having my flashlights on will do it. I'm hoping that's all it is. Then you would have thought maybe phrase would have been that they were deaf, not blind. Excuse me. I need to go to the red one rather than the white. I mean, ultimately, the white ones are all probably anglerfish. I guess the red one looks kind of claw-like. This is where I went before. This is all familiar, isn't it? Nope. They do not give a jeez, that made me jump. Oh my god, ow. Ow. That physically hurt. Okay. Don't give a shit about my flashlight being off. Do I have to just send my scouter and they chase that, maybe? Thank you, son. No, thank you, son. I'm hoping it's my scouter, because I can't think of anything else I can do. Let's just eat your entire ship in there and see what happens. This is going to go horribly, horribly wrong. I wonder what other structures I might be missing in the dark. I'm just heading towards the red thing. For now, let's just assume. Oh, there are other core things. Ooh. I mean, red still seems more important, but let's check out some white ones just in case. It feels like each of these knots is actually bigger than I imagine. That could be my scale being warped. I think. I'm just going for it. That is a fish. Probably guess that all the white ones are fish. Nice short loop. We're learning nothing. I still hurt from that jump, jeez. Ooh, that probe's taking its time. It almost looks like I can reach it. I probably can't. I want to play this game in VR, you know? Imagine how cool that would be. Yeah, it's quite close to the sun. It's safe. I feel like this could easily work as a VR game, actually. If they're working on something like that. Because the controls, all the kind of retro rockety things, like, feels very VR friendly. I feel like we are being warped into different spaces. Because before everyone was saying, oh, like, oh, well, the signal, like, or the seed seems to be, like, bigger than it seems, and it's like, no, it's just warping to Dark Bramble, surely. Nope, he doesn't give two shits. Yeah, we definitely changed dimensions there, or changed something. Velocity. So a quick land. Really at a loss as what to do other than do we have to just sneak around the outside somehow? And, like, anglerfish aren't even on here. Like, all of these have to do with, like, the different planets, I guess. Maybe it's down here. No. You know, Dark Bramble itself isn't even a core element. What's going on? It seems. Alright, let's try again and just try and be. Just gotta see about it. Okay. Let's hope he's just not just waiting there for us as soon as we go. We were, he was. Even see him. He's just waiting there on the boundary, just gonna get ya. So what do I do? It's a good question. If is they're blind, isn't the question then more how do they sense? And is it just their little angly things? They just need to not go near those. I don't feel like I was there. I was near them in the first place. It's true that sneaking around the outside is something I've not tried yet. dread trying, but... Got any other ideas? So the thing I can't work out at the moment is, am I supposed to go to Giant's Deep first and figure out how to get into the electrical field to then find a way to find Feldspar? Or do I need to find Feldspar to find out how to get to Giant's Deep? Because in some ways it feels like if I talk to Feldspar, he can tell me everything he knows about Giant's Deep anyway. So then I wouldn't need to go there to learn anything, so that doesn't feel right. I wonder if I'm, like, approaching this wrong. I don't think I am. I mean, nah, it's all the same, it looks like. Like it. Don't like it. Again. It's a close dense pattern, kind of makes me imagine it might be one of the ships. Oh. Wait, what? And that one. Oh god, what am I getting myself into? Please just don't be anglerfish. Why would it give me a hint that they're blind if I can't figure out a way around them still? Like, I want to hurry up and I also don't. Okay, it's another seed. He looks a bit enclosed in the others have been. So the seeds are kind of like black hole, white hole thing. This is not going to give me any answers. Or do I have to do that and then go to one of the duplicates? Until I figure out which is the real one. Ship. No, that's the scout. Oh god, confused. That's the scout, there's my ship. God, what does this mean? Don't like it. Don't like any of this. Some music going on. Yay. If this just comes up, I got another seed. Like, what do I do then? Shit. Oh. Oh no, hello. That's got trees in it. He looks like a dead fish, and this looks like a cam. I think we found him, lads. Man, Felsborough, if you were alive, I have words. Stuck now. Stop getting stuck on trees. Just land. Trees and teeth. Oh my god. You know what? Sure. There we go. We're parked. You've got stuff to answer, mate. Whoa. Where'd you come from? No one's come in here in, well, ever, actually. That makes you the second Hearthian to ever eat Dark Bramble. After me, of course. Well done. Just punch him. Say, it's you. They made you an astronaut, and you haven't blown yourself up yet? Good for you. I have done that many times. What spot? You're alive. You never were the brightless hatching, were you? Just... Yeah, that's right. I'm alive. Been coming out here since my ship, crashed. Violently. Wait, what? Oh, this is a good story. I'd just finished exploring the core of Giant's Deep. I needed a new challenge, and none of us had ever been inside Dark Bramble, so I thought, hey, let's give that a try. I've been cruising around here for a while, dodging the odd massive interdimensional vine bristling with thorns, where I run into this huge anglerfish, the biggest I've ever seen. I pull a few stones, try to shake the thing off. Nothing too fancy. I'm going full speed when the fish clips me, locks me into a vine, and... well, like I said, I crash. Blammo. On impact, my ship starts making noises like it's coming apart from the inside, and I think, well, that ain't great. Sure enough, I better get out of there before the electrical system starts sparking like crazy. It's either move fast or die unpleasantly, so I had to put a little distance between me and my poor fried ship. I camped out near where I crashed at first, found this skeleton later. Great find. Would have been stupid not to use it. I moved my setup over here, planted my emergency tree seeds, been here ever since. Wow. Yeah, pretty much. Anyway, that's how I went down, hatchling. Story's over, but feel free to stay and enjoy the fire a while. Or don't. Fire's not going anywhere. Reach the core of Giant's Deep. How'd you do it? Giant's Deep core, that was a wild one. Since you're asking, I've got to assume you haven't made it down there yourself yet, right? If I tell you now, it feels like cheating. On a completely unrelated note, that sure was a big hollow vine my ship crashed into. Yep. No, that just sounds like he's talking about the whirlpool. Well, maybe not. If I were you, I'd go take a walk and see where it ends. You'll want to go to the tail end of this anglerfish skeleton here and look for a flickering light in the fog. That'll be my old ship. Path starts there. Okay. Here's a mothmallow stick. Your ship. Not far from here, as a matter of fact. If you go straight past the tail of this anglerfish skeleton here, you'll see a flickering light in the fog. Follow that, you'll find my old ship. What's left of it, anyway. But he doesn't seem to be completely bothered about going home. What happened to this anglerfish? Oh, the skeleton? It's like this when I got here. As near as I can tell, this anglerfish must have been chewing on the vine and eating a seed, and then the seed grew and grew in the poor fish's stomach until this happened. Gross, huh? This skeleton was a good find. The light keeps the fish away, you know. See, they're territorial, so they mostly avoid each other. That's why I set up camp here. The light keeps the fish away. I must have had my flashlight on last time. Shouldn't I tell ground control to come get you? Well, yeah, sure. Whenever you have the time. Frankly, I kind of like out here. Quite peaceful. Fish. You're a little young to understand, but it's a lot of pressure being the best that ever was. Nice to have a break. Just kick him into orbit. We should explore here. That's the spirit. Anyways, good, but you should know that space is weird here. Intensely. You ever tried throwing your probe into one of those weird seeds? See there, with the little opening? It's just big enough to launch one through. Your probe jack will probably tell you the probe is two places at once, but I don't think that's wrong exactly, because space doesn't work right in here, and that seed looks small, see, but inside, it's bigger. Much bigger. I've had a lot of time to think about this, and my theory is space in Dark Bramble kind of expands as you go through each sphere. That's why it's bigger inside those seeds. Oh, that's my theory. Keep that in mind while exploring Dark Bramble, and maybe you won't get lost inside forever. Good luck. I found a Dark Bramble seed on Timperf. That's bad business, Hatchling. As Chet will tell you, if you so much as glance in Dark Bramble's direction, there used to be a fifth planet where the Bramble is now. This infernal plant appeared at the center and kept growing and growing until it shattered the planet and scattered its pieces across space. If we don't get that seed you found sorted real quick, like, I suspect Timberhearth will be heading towards the same fate. And I tell you what, we Hearthians have overcome far too much to be done in by some worthless seed. I found Noma writing saying anglerfish are blind. Aha, so the blasted things do have a weakness. Meaning my fly as fast as I can approach to dealing with them could have used a bit more thought behind it. Ah, well, at least they didn't eat me. All's well that ends well, eh, Hatchling? Doesn't say what the weakness is. I mean, I guess I'll have to try just flashing at them and see if it does anything. Alright, so this is you. Alright, here we go. Can you see anything else? Nope. Put you away. Alright, we must. Oh, gravity crystal keeping us here, that's fine. Oh my god, you are tiny! Just yeet him into space. Alrighty then. Let's make use of the time we've got now. Wait, where did you plant? How did you plant trees here? Oh, okay. Base count, how's it going? Alright, so let's go towards this flickering light. Oh, still don't like it. Still don't like it. I'm guessing we can't repair it, but it'd be nice if we could. Ooh, Jesus. Okay. Was expecting that. What does that tell us? Okay. Sure. I guess just don't bother with his ship, I guess. And also no, we ain't repairing it. Alright, let's go through this hollow vine, see where we end up. Feldspar's getting kind of tight. Oh, and gravity's gone weird. doing quite a bit of damage, actually. Dick. We are in the middle of nowhere. Oh no, that was my ship. Oh, my ship is gone. I wonder where that is. I'm still on Dark Ramble, okay. Still here. Okay. Trip 4, question mark. Entry number, I'm going to say not 1. Crashes, 3. Boring crashes, 0. A personal best. Whoa, never thought I'd see one of these beasties outside of Giant's Deep. They were awfully useful back there. Maybe a jellyfish could be useful here too. So we do have to use the jellyfish somehow. Blech, this thing tastes terrible. The outside is all rubbery and tough. Maybe that's because it insulates the jellyfish's insides from getting zapped by electricity. Right, I'm going inside of this jellyfish's interior cavity to see if what's in there tastes any better. Okay, yeah, we have to just somehow get inside. But like, I just bounced off it, didn't I? Where is the interior cavity when it's at home? Note to Feldspar, do not eat this even if you are dying. It would be too sad if this were the last thing you ever ate in this life. I guess these jellyfish are only useful for insulation from electricity. Again, do not eat. Love, Feldspar. Okay, well, there's our answer. Don't know how I'm going to manage it, but I did have that guess, and I just kind of just failed at doing it. Okay. Now what? I mean, I guess the short answer is I die horribly, and we restart and try Dark Ram. Giant's Deep. Is my ship showing in a weird place then? Because I parked it next to Feldspar, didn't I? Well, tally-ho. I'm wondering how much more there is to explore about this place, because it just seems like death and murder is the ultimate end of all things here. My ship has just gone for a wander. Alright, okay. Can I talk to him about it? I found the frozen jellyfish near your ship. Ah, so the old thing's still there, is it? That's where I first camped after the crash, you know. It's pretty cozy inside. It does lack the structural integrity and indomitable spirit of a campmate in the shelter of the very bones of the species that tried to eat you, I suppose. Still, very cozy. That's all he's got to say about that. Okay. I still feel like we've got to go and explore the red thing. Just don't know how we're going to do it. Oh, on earth I'm going to get out of here? That's another question. Let's just go for it and see what happens. Oh. That's what happens. I hit some floor. Yes, I approached him from that direction. Because I can't see any other lights to go towards. I suppose I could follow some vines. See where they go. A crash. Oh, that thruster's dead. Okay. I don't want to really fly around two lines, you know? It's just going to waste time. Where's the... Because it might be a lot quicker to... loop again. It's not going to be anywhere I know where I am. I say know where I am like I know anything. There we go. And well, quickest way to... loop is probably find an anglefish. This feels like a way out. It is. Big boy. Oh, there's the red thing. Let's go for you. Headlights on, tally-ho. This is some noises. Wait, what? Something coming out of there. Oh god, he's... Oh god, hello. Space now. He didn't look very scared. God, no, he doesn't give a shit about me, headlights. Tally-ho! Oh god, then what? The weakness is they're blind, but they can see me just fine. They're scared of light, but not my light. Maybe I can just pelt it past them like Feldspar did, but... my luck with pelting my ship through anything is not good. Whatever the red thing is, I'll probably just pancake on it. Anyway, at least we know something. Giant Steep, here we come. Learn about the probe module, which will hopefully tell us where the probe is now. Thank you. It's a lot of speed. It's a lot of speed. Okay, we're good. Clockwise, clockwise, clockwise. Anti-clockwise. Sup. Come on, in. If I go from the very bottom, it'll be alright. So, well done, friend. It's you. I didn't go too plan. Maybe I have to. Oh, hang on. Yeah, I only just about fit in it as a person. My entire ship's not going to fit in it. I am good at video games. I'm surprised it, like, absolutely killed me that time, though. But I probably touched the core a couple more times. Oh god, hello, Quantum Moon. You're a bit close today. Isn't it that close? Crash into the launch platform. Here we go. Oh god, hello. Counterclockwise, hello. This is nice and quick to get back to this area. Are you going up or down? You're going up. Should probably take a while, so let's go to this big boy over here. Should probably, I guess, leave my ship. Just chilling. Might regret everything. We're in. Oh god, now do I work out when we're in there or not? Oops. God, this is taking all my thrusters just to stay here. Myself here. Oh god. Guess we're through. Looks like our boy. Oh, the tension. I'm feeling it. I'm really feeling it. Okay, cool. Oh, it's nice and dry in here. Hooray. Oh, yeah. Of course, the gravity things. Oh, God. No, put you away. Sweet oxygen. Oh, the statue's eye open. No, Feldspar wouldn't have been here. He crashed long before that. Whose statue's this, then? Interesting. First of all, Ash Twin, you've got to tell us about that. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. 3 statues. I think that's why we keep seeing this. That's telling us there are 3 people who have their memories throughout loops. There's us, there's the dude on Giants. Giants Deep. Who else? I have exciting news, Brewitt. The Ash Twin Project is almost prepared to receive the probe data from the orbital probe cannon. Remy is adding some finishing touches here, but should be soon finished. Are you in the orbital probe cannon well? We are. The probe tracking module is ready to record each launch's flight trajectory and will automatically transmit all relevant data to you. From the other appendage, I'm now worried about this cannon's structural integrity and its crew's moral integrity. Once the probe determines the location of the Eye of the Universe, I'll send an alert directly to you and Remy. I think that we've read that. Maybe not. But we've got another stone. Launch module protection stone. And yeah, we've been here. Yeah, we've been here. Okay, cool. I've got to remember that some of these could have been done in different orders. So these are probably clues that I no longer need. Imagine Privet. Imagine Privet. The probe tracking modules will be the first to know the coordinates of the Eye of the Universe. You'll be the first to see it. Now we ever read this. I'm honored and terrified. Okay, but if this is the probe tracking module, let's get probe tracking, shall we? Oh, stay down. Come back. Okie doke. So that's Giants Deep in the launch. Oh. Ooh. Receiving data from probe 9409. Visualizing current trajectory of probe 9409. Meow. Okay. We only sent one probe. Oh God, whoa. Retrieving previous launch data from Ash Twin. Total number of probes launched, 9409. Deep space anomaly matching all known criteria for the Eye of the Universe found by probe 9354. I thought we hadn't launched a single probe. Other than just now. Or is that part of the loop? Retrieving stored coordinates from Ash Twin. Displaying coordinates for the Eye of the Universe. Cool. Glad we can read that. Wondering, it's like the third. Is it like the memories of the probe, and we've just gone through infinite loops where the probe's been firing off in random directions to try and find the eye? Who knows? Or is there a third person with memories that we haven't met yet? Where would they be? Where would they be? Tell me your secrets. Tell me. Hmm. I thought we'd get something that actually has a projection stone for, like, the probe. Hmm. translate that to anything useful, I guess. Oh, Christ, I remember this. Let me help. Is there anything else in this horrible catastrophe of a place? What is this one's at home? I guess it doesn't look like dark brown, but it's more like coral. If I like to get out, I'd have to go back into a jellyfish. That's a lot of effort. Let's just loop and see what our ship says, I guess. This is going to go well. Oh, no, okay, we can just come out. So now we know where the Eye of the Universe is. Can we go there? Like, it's an obscenely long way away, so I don't know if our ship would ever make it. Do we have to do something crazy with Dark Bramble to get there? Also, I don't want to go into space when the island. Oh god. This looks like good times. Okay. Alright, ship log, what do you have to say? The optical probe cannon has launched thousands of probes. The 9,354th probe located a deep space anomaly matching all known criteria for the Eye of the Universe. The probe tracking module automatically records each probe's trajectory and transmits the data to the Ash Twin project. I found it on my coordinates marking the location of the Eye of the Universe. Cool. Feldspar is alive. They crashed their ship and is now camping inside a huge anglerfish skeleton. Feldspar doesn't think my scout tracker is wrong when it says my scout is in two places at once. They have a theory that space doesn't work the same inside Dark Bramble. Feldspar doesn't sound overly eager to return to civilization. They've been enjoying the relative peace and quiet. Does it get any closer? I wish I remembered what the colour coding meant. There's more to explore than it's not. Then what? What? What does it say about Statue Island still? Some caves. You know, I could check out that cave. There's more to explore on the quantum moon locator. Really? Curious. Where was that? That was on Ember Twin? Please don't say there's more to discover there. Okay, cool. I still gotta find the vessel. The vessel's somewhere in there, which is probably what's written. Probably the red thing is the vessel. Escape. Oh, I've got to find escape pod 3. It It's what core broke when the ship crashed into our ramp, which might be part of the reason for what's going on. But I'm at a loss as to what to do now. Back to Timberhearth and see the Quantum Cave. Like, it feels like it's tutorial-ish, so actually, you know what, just... Oh. I missed a vital step in my grand suicide plan. Doesn't get any easier. I feel like the room that it was in wasn't... So I don't know if we can ever use that to teleport. Let's get my suit at least. It's easy to get around. Just go around telling everyone that Feldspar's alive. Yeah, this is all surrounded by lights. I can't do anything about that. Got to stand on it. Okay. Let me see if I'm nearby. Really? No, it's just that one. Okay. Because I tagged it, I guess. Get up. The landing gear of one of our ships that flew close. Like, what, are they starved that tiny? Those things are big now. Gravity crystals. So actually, these were explained then. Yeah, I remember seeing this now. Because I quite like the idea that we found these on walls and just saw them as lights, and it's not until you, like, try and jump on the wall that you figure stuff out. But no, I was just an idiot. Try the grove, but I don't think I can learn anything here. Such a cool map. I wish like we could zoom around a bit more, not like the limit it usually gives us. Boop, boop, boop. Okay, no, nothing to learn here. Trap me, stone. Probably go to the crater as well and say, yeah, don't let that sit here. Probably won't listen. No. Nope. doesn't help me at all. Thunk. There we go. Just because I can. It's probably worth me like revisiting some places like the moon and that, just to see if there's anything I understand better now. Is that the grove? I feel like it is. Here lies this river. Oh. Okay. Let's not be here. I don't particularly want to be in a graveyard. Okay, no, this is not a grave. Binary semaphore, okay. Sure. I need to get a loss as to what I can do now. Let's go to the giant steep. Actually, no, because I want to get there in a certain part of the loop. Let's go to in between. See if I can figure out what I'm missing from. Oops. What I'm missing about the moon locator. Oh. That one. Autopilot, not look at my feet. Whoa, that's a lot of speed. What can I learn from this thing? still yet to use the camera trickery to do anything with it. Like, that must come into play on the Quantum Moon, I guess, but... My world. Ow. Just pancake on a rock for no reason. That's what I'm missing. Oh, and that. Yeah, that'll be what I'm missing. Chert's research notes. Prophecy of Chert. Clearly the Nomai were making astronomical observations here. They chose an excellent spot. What is this big rotating device for? What is it the Nomai were observing? I'd posit there's something special about the orange symbol in that device. Alan, the new astronaut translator tool, would be a nice to have handy about now. Funnily enough, that is what I have. That would also have been handy, yeah. I'm trying to do the stuff with Ash Twin. Alright, it's this I need to bring over here. The quantum moon locator is functioning. We have markers for each of the places the moon goes. Anona, Burr, I just observed the quantum moon in orbit around Dark Bramble. I've added a marker for Dark Bramble. I thought the locator now accounted for all of the Phantom Moon's locations, but sometimes the locator can't tell where the moon is. Perhaps it's a problem with the device. It's also possible there exists a sixth place in the star system to which the Phantom Moon travels. Possibly the eye? You have keen eyes, my friend. So this moon travels to a total of 5 locations, not 4. Oh no, that's for Bramble, so no, there are 6. There are 6. Okay, so maybe that was all I was missing. And I literally parked next to it as well. Quantum moon travels to 5 locations. That is a lie. There we go. I feel like Dark Bramble's a little bit left. So it could be we've been looping for a crap ton of time and we haven't been keeping our memories. Because the memory thing only works once it's found it, so this has been going on time and time and time and time again. And it only activated the memory statues once it had found the eye, which then woke us up to the loops. This is my theory. This is my working theory. I like it. Zoom in. Tells me nothing. It's the hint I got from... I forget the name already. Tomasuri was... Someone teaches me... Or was it Indian lore? Someone tells me that I get taught meditation. Who would teach me anything? Unless I've really missed something on one of the shrines. Or someone's in an escape pod. Okay, Dark Bramble it is. Dark Bramble for everything. I don't know how I'm going to live. Let's fly into the sun. So we can get a clean loop. Okay, I can try just eating myself past the anglerfish. I can outrun them, technically. I guess. Seems a bit fruitless. And I feel like if my theory is correct, then yeah, we've been looping 10,000 times. That feels like that would be by design. And that might explain the 22 minutes. Maybe 22 limits is how long they reckon it takes the probe to get to the distance they reckon the eye is. So they designed this to just basically keep firing it and loop back 22 minutes and keep doing it until eventually it worked. Maybe that was their grand plan. I'm wondering how I'm going to find out information like that. No, I still want to go to Giant's Deep and see if I can see what happens when we get flung into space, because that still feels super relevant to something. Let's do that first. Statue Island. Can't go on too much longer at all. Just need to make dinner. In fact, I'm going to have to do this and then end up. Holy shit. It's not the island I want anyway. This is when I want to be here, so hopefully this happens at least one more time. Did I need to be here or upstairs? Upstairs, okay. Hopefully happens a few times per loop then. Grief. either here or in here. Here we wait. Fun and thrilling stream times. Back in a moment. Sorry to keep you waiting so that we can wait some more. I really hope this means something, because yeah, these were glowing pillars when we were in space. Most of them don't seem to move, so I don't know if I can even predict when you're going to hit. Hello. Seems a little bit noisy. Oh, here we go. Oh, is that it? Disappointing. And it makes sense, that's exactly what they're for. They're to keep you in place when everything hits, I guess. Oh man, we waited all that time to find out. Nothing. Okay, that's gonna have to be it, because I'm gonna make dinner before we play Fallout tonight. Because we are playing Wastelanders! We learn nothing. I think Escape Pod 3 is our next thing. Okay, we're going to have to leave it there. Thank you for joining me in this journey, guys. Should have some time to carry on tomorrow, hopefully. It is the weekend. Hurrah. All I can think is we've got to go back to Dark Bramble and figure out how to deal with the anglerfish. I have no idea how. But that is a problem for tomorrow. So thank you, guys. I'll catch you later.